Welcome back! This video is the one we've all been waiting for. Setting up a database cluster. So when you come here, the welcome screen will show up. Now if you close it, the way to get that screen back up is you can click this Get Started button, or you can click this Deploy button. Same thing. We are going to deploy a new database cluster, so this is the option that we want. Now a form will come up that you can start filling out, but hold up, bro. You don't just want to start filling stuff out because there's all kinds of these options and buttons. So before you start filling all this out and going through the pages, make sure you're on the right tab. Specifically, we are going to be using MySQL Galera. So that's the one we are going to click. Now we can start filling out the form. Now I mentioned earlier we need passwordless SSH enabled, and this user here is the SSH user. So we did it with the Caleb user. And we're also going to put a password so that way the sudo command can be used once there's SSH connection. So all of the usernames and passwords have to be the same because it's only asking for one user and one password. It's not asking a user for each node and a password for each node. That's why I mentioned when you have a user, it needs to be the same user on all of the different nodes. So we can just type our password here, and you can see it's extremely secure. And down here, we're going to leave all of these checked, and then the next thing we're going to do is give it a really good cluster name. Oh, you can't use winky faces? Come on. Okay, I guess we'll just go with subscribe. Then we're going to click continue. Okay, more options, yeah. The vendor, well, these are different types of Galera. Now, this can get a little confusing, but essentially, Codership is the company that made Galera, and they made Galera for the default MySQL, which is the Oracle MySQL. So Oracle is the company that owns MySQL. So if you're just going with, you know, the vanilla default MySQL, this is the option you're going to want to go with. And then these ones are a little bit different. So MariaDB is sort of like MySQL. It was created by the original creators of MySQL. But once Oracle acquired MySQL, there was this big uproar. And out of that uproar, MariaDB was created. Now Percona, I think that kind of uses the original MySQL, but just kind of adds some stuff to it. But I'm not an expert. So if you want to know more about all these things, go look it up. But let's go with MariaDB for this one. Now over here, we're going to create a password for the root user of this database on all of these nodes. So we just type password, or you type whatever you want. Now down here, we're going to actually type in the IP addresses of the nodes that are going to have this software installed. So if I remember correctly, it was 10.71.34.102, and then press enter, and then also 10.71.34.103. And there you go. So you can see we got the check marks, so everything is set up good. And you can see it even mentions it's reachable on SSH, so we know that is good. The next thing, we can just scroll down and click deploy. This is going to create a job, and you can watch that inside its activity viewer. If you click it, it's going to give you all of these messages going through the process. In the meantime, I'm just gonna do some drumming. This is taking forever. I'm having one of them days where I'm just like, what am I doing with my life? Oh. Usually that happens around 10 p.m., but I'm a little early today. I'm like super visionary, so I have like a new idea every single day of like this crazy business or this crazy new invention or this crazy idea I have. But my brain and body can only handle like half a task a day. So by the end of the day, I've thought so much and accomplished so little that I just go into this cycle of being overwhelmed and and then just get like nothing done. It's pretty bad. So my day-to-day process is wake up, figure out something to eat, and then kind of plan out my day. But you know, when I'm working and doing all this stuff, I'm not just working, I'm also like planning my future and my life, and you know, what am I going to be doing over the next 5 years, and what are my 10-year goals. And I'm really good at planning that kind of stuff, But when it comes to like planning stuff that's happening right now, I can't do that. Like someone will ask me, hey, are you going to come to this thing? And I'm like, well, the thing isn't until like, you know, 4 o'clock. So I really haven't decided yet. And then 3:50 will roll around. And I'm like, yeah, I'll go. Why not? I don't know where I'm going with this. So I was just, you know, throwing that out there. Oh my goodness, that took forever. I literally have the slowest internet here, so it takes a while. But we got this done, and you can see down here we have this subscribe cluster. You can click that, and it's going to give you all the information about that cluster. Oh, pretty charts. So what you can do is you can click this little logo here, and that'll kind of bring you to the homepage, dashboard, thingamajig. And that'll just get rid of all that activity junk. And now we have just our cluster here. So yeah, congrats guys. You just set up your first database cluster. And it only took you like 8 videos. 9? I think this is number 9. It only took you 9 videos. Now obviously it's going to take a long time for you to understand how to use all this information. And the goal of this series is not to cover all of that information. Consider that an exploring opportunity. My goal is to help you set up a cluster. I might make more videos in the future going over, oh, here's some performance things you can look at and yada, yada, yada. But for now, we got the database cluster going. There's a couple more things I want to talk about. So in the next video, we're going to be talking about something new, still related to this database cluster though. So it's really important. Make sure you check it out. If you've enjoyed these videos, please be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.